Thank you.
All right. Should I get started?
Yeah.
Let's wait till 3:30. Do you want to start? Do you want to tell them to take their seats?
All right. Welcome, one and all. If we could please have everybody take a seat, we will begin shortly.
Yay!
Go Bears. Go Bears. Go Bears.
We should do the bear chant at the end.
Oh, no.
Then we could probably wait for one more minute.
Yeah. 15 seconds.
It's crazy because we're live.
All right. Welcome, loved ones, campus partners, guests, and class of 2023.
Woo!
We also want to say hello to our guests who are watching through the live stream. Hello. Thank you for joining us. We are excited to be here with you all at the 6th annual UndocuGrad celebration.
Woo!
Celebrating our lovely graduates and 10 years of the Undocumented Student Program. Let's give a round of applause.
Woo!
My name is Keisha Aurin. I use they, them pronouns. I graduated from UC Berkeley with a degree in sociology. I was also a USB alum, and now I proudly serve as one of the academic counselors at USB.
And my name is Ratu Orisi Labalavu. I go by Orisi for short. I am a recent graduate, graduating in anthropology and social welfare, and I am an incoming master's student.
We are honored to be your hosts today.
Before we start with our first speaker, we would like to acknowledge that UC Berkeley sits on the territory of the Huichin, the ancestral and unceded land of the Chochenyo-speaking Ohlone people, the successors of the sovereign Verona Band of Alameda County. We recognize that every member of the UC Berkeley community has and continues to benefit from the use and occupation of this land since the institution's founding in 1868. Consistent with our values of community, inclusion, and diversity, we have a responsibility to acknowledge and make visible the university's relationships to Native peoples. As members of the Berkeley community, it is vitally important that we not only recognize the history of the land on which we stand, but also recognize the Mwekma Ohlone people are alive and flourishing members of the Berkeley and broader Bay Area communities today. That said, we would like to thank Chancellor Carol Crist for hosting us here today, and we welcome her to join us on stage.
Good afternoon. I'm Carol Crist, UC Berkeley's Chancellor, and I'm grateful for this opportunity to congratulate you, the truly amazing students we're here to celebrate. Graduating from this university is an incredible accomplishment for all students, even in the best of times. Given the challenges you've faced as undocumented members of our campus family, and given the perseverance and resilience that was required to surmount the obstacles the pandemic placed in your path, your accomplishments are all the more impressive and profoundly deserving of our pride and respect. You have, each and every one of you, risen to the occasion time and time again. We're humbled and made better by your strength and dedication. I also want to express my appreciation and gratitude to all of you who have supported these students on the way to this major milestone in their lives, families, friends, and the wonderful staff, faculty, and alumni who contribute to the important work of our Equity and Inclusion Division, our Latinx Thriving Initiative, and our Student Experience and Diversity Program. In particular, I want, on behalf of our entire campus community, to extend special thanks to Elise Haas, to Bob and Colleen Haas, Joseph Hellerstein, Adene Sachs, and former Chancellor Robert Bergineau, who was a champion for undocumented students during his time in office and remains an essential advocate to this day. Together, you embody and exemplify the extent to which we all thrive when there's community, connection, caring, and collaboration. There could be no more fitting time than today to acknowledge and celebrate the founding 10 years ago of our Undocumented Students Program. While the campus provided support to undocumented students prior to 2012, we've come a long way since then, with USP now an integral and essential part of our equity and inclusion efforts. And let us not forget that, as is so often the case here at Berkeley, it was student-led activism and engagement that spurred the university to do more, to do better, when it came to understanding and meeting the needs and interests of our undocumented students. The power of your voices is revered and respected. Nothing could be more fitting for a university made for the people, by the people. Over the course of recent years, we've witnessed and experienced the strength and resilience of our campus community, even when the ties that bond us together have been virtual. Students, faculty, staff, and alumni have come together in support of each other, our community, the excellence of our academic mission, and our shared values that revolve around diversity, equity, inclusion, justice, and belonging. We've strived to provide one and all with holistic support and a safety net so that students can thrive. We've worked hard to back our words with the sort of deeds that make manifest our commitments and beliefs, all in the service of our quest to educate and enlighten in support of a better, more equitable world. In the face of far too many instances of racism, bias, and discrimination, our campus community has stood and will continue to stand in solidarity with all who are here today fighting for justice and equity in our country. We will, together, continue forward with our commitment to create a university, and by extension, a society, where everyone feels a true, authentic sense of belonging. For these and for so many other reasons, we also continue forward with our work to increase the diversity of our community, students, staff, faculty, and alumni alike. I believe that as a public university, we must represent and reflect the state and the people we serve, particularly those from historically underrepresented backgrounds. I know that one of the wonderful qualities you have in common with each other and this university is a commitment to advancing the greater good. Now more than ever, our communities, our country, the world, need all that you have to offer as the beneficiaries of a world-class Berkeley education and experience. I can't wait to see what you will do on the road ahead with all that you carry from Cal. We're immensely proud of what you've done and even more of who you will become. You made us a better university, a better community by virtue of your presence, your resilience, and your extraordinary contributions. Congratulations, and go Bears!
Thank you so much for your remarks, Chancellor Chris. Can we give her another round of applause? Now, we are happy to welcome our very own Vice Chancellor for Equity and Inclusion, Dania Matos, to the stage. Woo!
Thank you so much for having me. Buenas tardes. Good afternoon. I forgot it in French, but I do speak French right now. Thank you, Chancellor Chris, for your words of welcome. It is always good to be in community with you. And this is my first UNDOCU-grad ceremony, so just by nature of that, it is also very, very special to me. So just, I'm taking a moment to take it all in. It looks amazing from up here, y'all. So just turn to your neighbor, just say thank you for being here.
Thank you for being here.
You're the best. You're amazing.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah, there we go. As our amazing MC said, my name is Dania Matos, and I use she, her, ella pronouns. I'm the Vice Chancellor for the Division of Equity and Inclusion. And I just like to share a little bit of beyond the bio. I was raised by a single mom, and my mother always instilled in me that I had a responsibility to do something about the world, and that I was inheriting a struggle. And that's something so many of you have already taken on. So I look forward to seeing where that responsibility takes each and every one of you. You, the Undocumented Student Program, graduating class of 2023, are about to become, oh, I heard a little, ooh, yeah, give yourself a little ooh. That's right, all the snaps. You're about to become UC Berkeley's newest alums, and I'm beyond honored to be with you here today. Thank you for sharing your graduation day with me, and as I shared my first. There's no question that today is about you. Hoy es para ti, graduates. I hope you let all the love, respect, and joy fill your hearts. You faced enormous challenges, some of which we know and some of which no one will ever know. But before and during your time on campus, you turned them into opportunities. That is a hard-won skill, and I know one that will serve you for years to come. And now that you're a part of UC Berkeley's community, you'll have an abundance of folks you can reach out to whenever life's challenges come calling. I promise you we have your back. So I wore my monarch butterfly earrings today in honor in each of every one of you, to symbolize the support and the understanding of each of your struggle. Days like today are only possible with support systems, and it's good to remember how these systems come in so many different forms. Families of all kinds, friends, advocates, and mentors, to name a few. Someone who just, you know, says, you're amazing today, walking down the street. I'd like to echo Chancellor Chris's support with a special thanks to our community of supporters, alumni, champions, staff, and faculty members, and the Undocumented Student Program team for consistently showing up with care for our students, and many of them in the room today. I'm going to give you a shout out, but they're there in the back, Lily and Meng. My thanks must, oh yeah, let's do it now. We're going to give you all the love. My thanks must extend several years back to acknowledge our inaugural Vice Chancellor for Equity and Inclusion, Gabor Basri, and the Undocumented Student Program's founding director, Meng So. Their leadership positioned UC Berkeley to be the first higher ed institution to establish the Undocumented Student Program, and had since inspired other institutions across the nation to follow. Thank you, Meng and Gabor. Today, on the 10th anniversary of this program, we're honoring the establishment of something that didn't previously exist here, something that is impactful, sustainable, and reflective of the world we live in. It was established in 2012. The Undocumented Student Program has blossomed, become an intrinsic part of our efforts to imagine and co-create a campus and a community where everyone thrives. Under Liliana Iglesias' leadership, or Lily, as we know her. Oh! Go ahead, Lily! Wave to your fans. The program is a model for supporting undocumented students in higher education and continues to pave the way in its leading practices and holistic approach. I know we've come a long way since campus leaders first started listening and providing support to undocumented students, and I'm so heartened by this legacy of what's possible. And I look forward to being an ongoing part of the transformative work to create a more welcoming and just environment for all students. UC Berkeley is known and respected for its student-led activism. The influential power of your voices is now becoming a part of that legacy. So I want you to keep sharing your brilliance and your shine with your communities, and especially when it's hardest, at the world as you begin to make your next moves. Your narratives are forever part of our collective stories for liberation and our long-standing tradition for excellence in higher education. Students, you're surrounded right now by people who are supremely proud of you and what you're accomplishing today. UC Berkeley is a brighter community and is made more distinguished with you in it. I give you my congratulations, class of 2023. It's time to celebrate. A celebrar. Go Bears! Go Osos!
Wow. Thank you, Vice Chancellor Matos. Can we just give her another round of applause? Now, I am very excited to introduce our keynote and alumni speaker, Ju Hong. Woo! Ju is the director of the UCLA Dream Center, a program team of the UCLA Labor Center that empowers immigrant youth and allies to be at the forefront of social justice movements. Ju has over a decade of experience in the immigrants' rights movement and often shares his immigration story at conferences and universities to educate and inspire people to take action on immigrant issues. In 2013, Ju challenged former President Obama on his administration record number of deportations during a presidential speech at the Betty Ong Center in San Francisco, California. His courageous actions appeared on national and international media, including the New York Times, Washington Post, CNN, and BBC News. Ju currently serves as the board chair of the National Korean American Service and Education Consortium, and as a member of the Leadership Council of Immigrants Rising, an organization we know very well. Ju also brings an awareness to the unique stories of Asian undocumented individuals living in the United States through his podcast, The Immigrations. Ju graduated from UC Berkeley with a bachelor's degree in political science and graduated from San Francisco State University with a master's degree in public administration. While at UC Berkeley, Ju became the first undocumented student government senator in UC Berkeley history. In his spare time, Ju enjoys traveling, dancing, and spending time with his family dog, Mocha. Can we all give him a round of applause?
Oh, that was a whole intro.
Of course, of course. Thank you, thank
you, thank you. Wow. Good afternoon. I am deeply honored to be here today as returning as alum to celebrate with amazing allies and faculties and proud parents and loved ones. And most importantly, I'm really excited to be standing with the inspiring class of 2023. As a proud Berkeley graduate of 2012, it feels really great to be back at my alma mater. And over 10 years have passed, and I must say, I'm still undocumented, single, trilingual, and ready to mingle from Monday to Domingo. Just like finding a life partner, I hold on to the hope that the DREAM Act will pass one day. And when it does, we will have one more reason to celebrate together. But today is your day. Today we celebrate your extraordinary achievements and the unique journeys that brought us here together. We must recognize the village that contributed to your success. Look around you, your family, your friends, and your mentors who supported your growth, development, and success. And just like you, I wouldn't be where I am today without the community support. As a first-gen undocumented student raised in a single-parent household, I navigated language barriers, cultural differences, an unfamiliar educational system. And I often felt alone and isolated as a Korean undocumented youth, believing that I was the only one grappling with this issue. However, at Cal, I stumbled upon a transformative organization called the Rising Immigrant Scholars Through Education, or also known as RISE, where I met incredible undocumented immigrant students advocating for the rights of undocumented immigrant communities. This is where I felt accepted as who I was, as surrounded by people who understood my struggles and shared visions for the collective future. And our unity was clear as we consistently came together in times of need, offering meals, lending books and supplies, securing places to stay, protecting families from deportation, providing resources to enhance personal and professional development opportunities for all students. And my experience with RISE not only gave me a sense of belonging, but also fostered lifelong friendship with inspiring peers who pursued their careers in medicine, business, and immigration law. And through RISE, we have organized annual AB 540 conferences to protest on immigration issues in front of Cedar Gate, Sproul Plaza, demanding rights for immigration. We stand on the shoulder of courageous undocumented student activists who came before us, whose tireless efforts paved the way for our work today. Our collective effort have led significant victories like the California Dream Act, Healthcare for All, and DACA, benefiting hundreds of thousands of undocumented immigrants across the country. And most importantly, our relentless advocacy led UC Berkeley to establish the first undocumented student program center at any UC campus and public university in the state of California. This groundbreaking achievement offers a safe space for students to access resources, support, and guidance while fostering a sense of community. And as we celebrate the 10th anniversary of the center's inception, we continue to honor its legacy by empowering future generations of undocumented students at Cal and beyond. So to the class of 2023, we celebrate your achievements and your boundless potential. And the friendships and communities you have forged here will provide support and encouragement throughout your journey. So cherish these relationships, for they are invaluable. And do not let your immigration status define who you are. You are enough. Pursue your passions and follow your heart. And regardless of your path, remember to give back to your community and always never forget your roots. So as we commemorate your graduation from the number one public university in the world, UC Berkeley, let us celebrate your accomplishments and let us work together to create a society filled with hope, compassion, and justice for all. Thank you. Go Bears!
Let's give it up again for Drew Hong! Drew, thank you so much for your uplifting words. We are so happy and honored to have you back here today. Next, we have a graduating student who will be sharing some words with us. As one of her staffers this semester, it is such a great pleasure to introduce Valeria Plasencia. Vale is graduating with a major in civil engineering with a minor in regional and city planning. Her creativity and passion for serving the undocumented community landed her as a position as a marketing and communications intern for USB for 2 years. So if you see our Instagram, that's her, which she will forever hold dear to her heart. After graduating, Vale hopes to continue working closely with undocumented individuals and promote opportunities available to them through her dedication for creating online content. In her free time, you can find Vale reading and drawing, but today, she's more than grateful to stand on the stage to celebrate you. Give it up for Vale. Woo!
Thank you. Welcome, UndocuGrads of 2023. I'm honored to be standing here to congratulate you and honor the strength that brought you here today. Because we all know about the daily struggles of being an undocumented student. It's not easy whatsoever. We carry an additional weight. We know loss. We know grief. We have felt excluded and that our voices do not matter. And yet, here we are. We used to be silent when people around us shared opportunities not available to us or spoke about their vacations outside the US. But today, I encourage you to be loud. Be as loud, as proud as you can be. Because even without those opportunities, you found your way and you made it. What might have felt impossible once is happening today, right now. Close your eyes. Feel it. Here is to you. When I was younger and the Oscars were on TV, my dad, brother, and I would get ready to compete against each other in guessing the winners for every category. My dad would tell you he would win most of the time, but I will let you know the truth. It was me. From this experience, I would daydream of the day where I got to win an Oscar and go on stage representing Peru, the country where I was born and raised. Viva el Peru. And I would get to thank all the people who supported me in this journey. Today, I'm not winning an Oscar yet. Nor did I major in theater. I am a civil engineer, by the way. But I'm on this stage, and I have given the chance to express gratitude for all the support that I've been given. And in all honesty, I do feel like I'm surrounded by celebrities and winners. I look up to you all deeply. We get to inspire future generations to continue moving forward. I'll repeat the words that Lupita Nyong'o said when she won her first Oscar in 2014. No matter where you come from, your dreams are valid. My 14-year-old self held on to this quote as she came into a new country with a book in one hand to give her enough strength to reassure her mom, who was holding her other hand, that everything was going to be okay. Although there was nothing more painful than leaving behind everything she loved about her culture and family, she was making a sacrifice to prove her right to an education. Today, the purpose has finally been fulfilled. We're graduating from the number one public university in the world, and nobody is denying her from that. Today might be better than receiving an Oscar, actually, because it is living proof that we as undocumented students keep fighting for an education without constraints, and we will not give up until we see it happening. During my first 2 years at UC Berkeley, I felt lonely. So many times I told my mom on the phone that I was okay, sorry mom, because it was easier than expressing the frustration of feeling different from other students around me. I felt invisible as a result of my identity. I kept blindly running to find a place where I could feel like I belonged, only to feel exhausted and even more lost. It was not until I received an email from the Undocumented Student Program, the best program ever, to apply to be a marketing and communications intern. Like I said, I'm a civil engineering major, but I also gave myself a chance to finally follow a creative path, so I took this opportunity and did not let go of it. USB has given me a safe space where I do not have to explain myself to be understood. I remember the time when I went to Daisy's office crying and spoke to her. Then we went to go get boba after a self-care. This was one of the first times I sought for help, and I do not regret it at all. That's the type of place that USP is. A place where you will be heard, you will feel seen, and you will feel supported. I will for sure not be standing here if it wasn't because of it. I'm eternally grateful to the staff, Lily, who is always there for me, Daisy, who cares about everyone deeply, Keisha, making people's days better with her laugh, and Camille, always willing to help if needed. You have been the best support I could have ever asked for. To my fellow USP interns and students, who I have the pleasure of meeting, you are my family, and having you there was always a reminder that I'm not alone. We are not alone. I'm proud of you, and I'm here to celebrate with you. A big thank you as well to my therapist, Bianca, for being there to teach me what healing looks like. And to my partner for being my number one fan, just like I am his. Before I leave this stage, I want to take a moment to honor my older brother. He lives all the way in Peru and unfortunately could not be here today. Sebas means the world to me, as he gave me and my younger brothers the best childhood I could imagine and was a second father figure to us. Although it's been a while, I think about you every day, I talk about you every day, and I feel you close no matter the distance. I am who I am because of you. A mi familia en Perú, los amo, extraño y pienso en ustedes todos los días. Gracias por apoyarme y siempre creer en mí. Este logro va para ustedes y mis abuelos quienes me vieron crecer. Papá, mamá, nada es imposible, ¿no? Lastly, in the words of my best friend and icon, Hannah Montana, I always knew this day would come. It's okay if you don't know where to go from here, if you have more than one passion like me. The wings have been given to you, and now you get to choose where to fly from here. I hope you choose wherever you're happiest. My favorite quote is from the novel Looking for Alaska. It's very beautiful over there. I don't know where there is, but I believe it's somewhere, and I hope it's beautiful. It will be beautiful, I promise. Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was a beautiful speech. Let's give her another round of applause. All right. And now the moment that we've all been waiting for. Could I please get a drum roll, please? So let me hear you make some noise for...
We invite the class of 2023 and their loved ones next to them to line up by the stage to my left. In a moment, each graduate will walk across the stage with two loved ones, and they will each get 30 seconds to share some words with us. Let's give them a round of applause!
All right. So while our graduates line up, we would like to invite some very dear staff members to the front. Could I please get USP psychologist Dr. Diana Pena and Dr. Bianca Barrios? They will be reading our graduates' names, congratulating our graduates, and providing them each with their diploma cover, our USP director, Lily Iglesias, and USP academic counselor, Camille Semisango. Our graduate procession will begin shortly.
Congratulations, graduates. We are about to start our procession. Is everybody ready? Great. Okay. All right. Our first graduate is Pascal Adele Bacou. Her degree is in molecular environment biology.
Everybody. I did see in the email that would get 30 seconds to say something. I wasn't sure too even right now what to say, but I'm just really grateful for UC Berkeley and USP to have been on my journey on this half part until I get to medical school. And I'm just really grateful again for everybody that's here today. I say thank you to my parents who couldn't make it, and also thankful to my Sikh grandparents that are looking for me from wherever they are. Thank you.
Celia Serrato, Bachelor's in Gender and Women's Studies.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here and sharing this space. I just want to propose that instead of vying for citizenship, we vie for a world where citizenship does not exist, where there's no such thing as a nation, a border, or state, or a man who can deny our life-given right of living in a world where the earth takes care of all of us. The earth never ever asked us if we had a social security before she gave us her water, her seeds, her soil, her air. And so no man, no nation, no state should ever have the right to do that. To a world with no borders. Love you.
Angela Laureano, Master of Public Policy.
I just want to say thank you to USP. I wanted to cry looking at Lily because she's known me since I was 18. I went straight to graduate school right after undergrad, and USP has been the best, providing mental health resources, financial resources, whatever, just to get us through. And I could not have done it without USP, and also my mom, both my moms, my mom and my grandma. So thank you, everyone.
Javon Guran, Bachelor's of Arts in Architecture.
Greetings, everyone presented here. Thank you for being part of Undocumented Student Program. Ju Hong, thank you for sharing your story. I feel like I'm going just like you. My name is Javon Guran. I was born and raised in Nepal. My dream is to become an American architect and work with people who have to struggle to be heard. I'm a first-generation college student, and I'm the only person who is living in the US. My parents could not make it today. I thank my family, relatives, friends, and everyone who have supported me through my academic journey. And thank you, USP, for providing all the support to all of us, especially Program Director Liliana, Dr. Bianca, Program Coordinator Daisy, and everyone working at USP. Go Bears, thank you.
Jerusalén Dávila, Bachelor of Arts in Chicano Studies.
Hi, primero que nada le quiero agradecer a mis papás que no pudieron venir, pero I want to thank them for always encouraging my siblings and I to pursue our goals. This is for my siblings. I look forward to watching you cross the stage when the time comes. To the undocumented student program, I wouldn't have be here today without your support. To the interns, to Keisha, Daisy, Camille, thank you for being my home away from home. Thank you for making a safe space for us. The work that you do for all of us doesn't go unforeseen. Thank you all.
Jose Entrequin, Bachelor's of Theater and Performance Studies.
Hi everyone, USP in the house, our interns. Congratulations to the interns and all the other grads, to our friends and allies. Thank you for being here. My dream is to be an actor and a director. And I have my awesome friends here with me today. So thank you for being here and supporting me along the way.
Ilse Mariana Gaviño Vargas, Master in Social Welfare.
Hello everyone, buenas tardes. Muchas gracias a todos por estar aquí. Muchas gracias a mis papás que me dieron la oportunidad de estar aquí. Lili, Bianca, Miroslava, Jessica. No sería posible estar aquí sin ustedes y darnos un lugar seguro, una casa dentro de Berkeley. Gracias.
Valerie Barkin, Bachelor's in History.
UC Berkeley been a very difficult time, full of challenges, but yet treasures as well. I don't regret anything. I am very grateful that I was able to attend this beautiful, diverse university. I am very grateful for my mother, who is unfortunately no longer with us, for bringing me here and giving me a chance in my education. I hope one day I will be able to change the world for the better and help the ones who really need our help in city planning and architecture so we can bring the community together. Thank you.
Maritza de la Torre Ayar, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology.
This has been such an unforgettable experience, filled with a lot of learning, growth, and unlearning. And I would like to thank everyone that helped me get to this moment. And thank you, Diana, so much for everything.
Jessica V. Rubio Rincon, Master in Public Policy.
Well, what once was a dream today becomes a reality. And I couldn't be more proud of this journey. Le dedico este logro a mi mamá, a mi hermano y a mi papá, que me cuida desde el cielo. While it took a village to get us here, it was our hearts, our tears, and our passion that allowed us today to close this chapter. undocumented, and unafraid. Ernesto Gutierrez Topete, PhD in Hispanic Linguistics.
Thank you. First of all, I want to thank my family who isn't here, but they're watching. Los quiero. A mis papás, a mis hermanos, este logro es por y para ustedes. Sin ustedes, sin su apoyo, sin su amor, no habría logrado esto. Thank you very much. I also want to thank my mentors, Lily from USP, Jessica from OGD, Alberto Ledesma, and everyone else who's standing next to them, because if I'm have as good a mentor as they have been to me, I will make my students very happy, I'm sure. And finally, I want to thank the administration and the donors who are present here or watching from afar. Without your contribution, this wouldn't be possible, so thank you very much.
Erandi Garcia, bachelor's in sociology and bachelor's in Spanish.
Buenas tardes. Este logro es para mis papás y mis hermanos. Y a todos que me ayudaron a llegar aquí.
Andres Garcia, bachelor's in conservation and resource studies and two minors, one in Spanish and in Chicano studies.
I just want to say thank you to everyone who made it, and to Juliana and the USP staff, and congrats to class 2023.
Elisa Montes Preciado, bachelor of business administration, the Haas School of Business.
I stand here today honoring all the unconditional love and support I've received from my loved ones and individuals who never stopped believing in me. My mom, my dad, Angie, Maggie, Steven, Shauna, and the Undocumented Student Program. You guys have all been crucial to me being here. Mami, aquí estoy cumpliendo el sueño de usted, lo hago por usted. Gracias por todo su sacrificio y por enseñarme cómo ser una persona fuerte y resilient. Aprecio todo lo que ha hecho por mí y lo hago por ustedes. We did not give up and we never will.
Sebastián García, Bachelor's in Business Administration and Psychology.
Buenas tardes. Quería tomar el tiempo para reflexionar y agradecer a las personas que me apoyaron en esta fase de mi vida. Sin el apoyo incondicional de mis seres queridos, no hubiese podido llegar donde estoy. Este logro es tanto mío como suyo. Muchas gracias a mis padres, hermanos y mis queridos abuelitos. Pero no puedo olvidar, obviamente, a este programa, Lily, Diana, Bianca, y a las personas que me apoyaron en el transcurso de mi vida académica. Sin su contribución, ese camino hubiese sido aún más difícil. Muchas gracias a todas las personas que me alentaron en este camino. Su apoyo no será en vano o será olvidado. Muchas gracias. Felicitaciones a todos los graduados. Y como decimos en mi país, sí se puede, sí se pudo y siempre se podrá. ¡Go Bears!
Eric Pineda, Bachelor's of Arts in Political Economy.
Hello everyone, thank you for being here. I just want to say a huge shout out to Liliana for always helping me throughout my 4 years here at UC Berkeley and to everybody who contributed to all the students' success here. Quiero agradecerle a mi mamá que me está viendo en su teléfono allá en la casa. So, gracias y la amo mucho. Thank you.
Joanne Coelho Nunez, Bachelor of Arts in Media Studies and Business Digital Studies.
Hola, quiero aprovechar este momento para expresar mi agradecimiento a USP, a mis seres queridos aquí presentes y a mi familia en Honduras, quienes me han apoyado y amado a lo largo de este camino. También quiero aprovechar para agradecerle a mi madre, quien tuvo la valentía de traerme a este país y quien ha sacrificado todo para ayudarme a cumplir mis sueños. Los amo, gracias.
Ana Sánchez Gutiérrez,
Bachelor of Arts in Public Health and a minor in Spanish Linguistics.
Thank you, USP, for always providing, being welcoming and supportive in my 4 years here. Gracias a mi familia, a mis papás, a mi abuelita, mi tía, my little bro. Thank you so much. Muchas gracias por siempre estar en mí, creer en mí. Esto es para ustedes. Muchas gracias. Soy la primera, pero no soy la última. Gracias.
Alondra Aguilar, Political Science.
Thank you so much, USP, for everything from mental health resources to just being there for all of us. Todo esto es para mis papás y mis hermanas, mis hermanos y mi hermana. Los amo. I also want to thank my partner, my friends that continue to be there and support me. I feel that I'm becoming the woman that I want to be. I can't wait for what comes next. Muchas gracias por creer en mí. Los amo. Viva México y Go Bears.
Woo! Giovanna Muñoz Ortiz, Bachelor's in Legal Studies.
Hello, everyone. After migrating from Mexico, I made my home in East Oakland, so I would like to thank the community that I met there, mentors that became friends, Bree, Nikki, friends, peers who are now lifelong friends, Rogelio, Brianna, and Daisy and Christina. Thank you for being there and supporting me, and shout out to my sisters who are also graduating from high school and kindergarten. Thank you everyone for being here, and my parents.
Maria Fernanda Castorena, Bachelor's in Sociology with a minor in Education.
Hola, muchas gracias a todos, pero muchas gracias a mi mamá, que va a estar viendo este video al rato. Le quiero decir gracias porque todos sus esfuerzos, su cariño y apoyo fue por todo mi crecimiento y todo lo que me enseñó fue una gran enseñanza. Gracias a todos mis amigos y mis comunidades por quererme, apoyarme y todos los momentos bonitos. Siempre los llevo en mi corazón y los quiero mucho a todos.
Rebecca Santiago Lopez, Bachelor's in Public Health.
Hi everyone, I just want to say thank you to the USP family for always being there. Thank you to my best friends that are here. Thank you for being my home away from home. Gracias mami y papi por traerme y no olvidarse de mí. Ese logro se lo dedico a mi mamá Aurora que me está viendo en el cielo.
Valeria Plasencia, Bachelor's degree in Civil Engineering with a minor in City and Regional Planning.
Irónicamente no preparé algo para esto, pero sí. Muchas gracias a mis papás que hoy se gradúan conmigo. También quiero agradecer a mis hermanitos Ignacio y Matías que están allá. Muchísimas gracias por acompañarme hoy. A mi hermano que está viendo la cámara. Y a mis amigos que me dieron una familia aquí. Gracias por estar aquí, los quiero.
Montserrat Roa Díaz, Bachelor of Arts in Legal Studies.
Hola, buenas tardes. Antes que nada quería decirle feliz día a las madres, a todas las madres aquí, especialmente a mi mami. A mis papás, gracias por enseñarme que en esta vida nada ni nadie me puede detener. Gracias por sus sacrificios y su esfuerzo. Esta va por ustedes. I also want to thank my sister for being my forever role model, for Ohlone College for getting me here. Woo-woo, go Transfers! And for USP for supporting me throughout my time here. This also goes out to my undocumented cousins, Yeremy and Carla, and an old friend, Gabriel. I hope I made you guys proud.
Cristina Acosta Navarro, Bachelor of Science in Conservation and Resource Studies and Bachelor of Arts in Ethnic Studies.
Hi, primero quiero felicitar a todas las mamás y a las abuelitas. Feliz día. Sin ustedes no estaríamos aquí. Gracias a mi mamá, a mi abuela, a mis hermanas, a mis mejores amigas y a todas las mujeres en mi vida que me han dado la fortaleza para seguir y quienes me han enseñado lo que es el amor incondicional. A mi abuelito genio que me guía desde el cielo, lo quiero mucho.
Jennifer Eileen García Hernández, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology.
Hi, I want to start off by thanking the Undocumented Student Program and all the interns that are now my dearest friends. Without y'all, I would not be here. Thank you. Graduarme de UC Berkeley es mi mayor logro y no podría estar más orgullosa de llegar finalmente aquí en comunidad a cumplir esa meta. Como estudiante y documentada y primer generación, esta experiencia fue lejos de fácil, pero estoy muy agradecida y bendecida de tener a mi padre, a mis hermanas y a mis amigos ahora que se han convertido en familia, como mi mayor sistema de apoyo y a lo largo de este viaje. Para mi padre y mis dos hermanas, este es nuestro título. Gracias.
Marifer Esquivel, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology.
Hi, y'all. I want to start off by saying Happy Mother's Day. And I just want to say thank you to everyone that's helped me to get to this point in my life, from my family that's watching from online, to my family and friends, and also the random people that I just met around campus, from the people at Strata that just hooked it up with coffee every single time, to, yeah, just everyone. Thank you so much, and yeah. Yay!
Daisy Barajas Villa, Bachelor of Arts in Sociology.
Hello. I want to say thank you to my parents, to my siblings, to my brother, and my partner for always pushing me and being my best friends and my number one supporters. Thank you.
Diana Lopez Allende, Bachelor of Arts in Integrative Biology and a minor in Portuguese.
I would like to first thank the Undocumented Student Program for all the support they've given me throughout my time at Berkeley. I would also like to thank my mom and my aunt, who are very strong women, and without them I wouldn't be standing here today. I'm the oldest grandchild, and I hope I serve to be an inspiration to the rest of my family, specifically my youngest sister, who I have a 12-year age gap, and I hope to see crossing the stage in like 12 years' time. And there's so many people who have helped me throughout my journey, and I can't name them all, but I want to thank them. And I would like to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers here today. And that's it.
Juan Ernesto Renteria, Bachelor's in Sociology with a minor in Chicano Studies and a focus in social work.
Muchas gracias a todos. Quiero saludar a mi papá, que está a un lugar en el universo, a mi mamá, que está viéndome en México, y dar este feliz Día de las Madres a mi second mom, right here, and best of luck for all of you undocumented grad students.
Let's give another round of applause for our class of 2023.
We have come to the end of the ceremony. Thank you all for your support you've provided to the graduates throughout their time at Berkeley. Today, we celebrate the class of 2023. Woo! Congratulations to you all and your loved ones and your community. We would also like to thank USP and the University Development and Alumni Relations staff for putting this celebration together.
Again, thank you all so much for celebrating with us today and for the support you've provided to our students one way or another. In a few minutes, we will transition to the reception. Please join us for food, beverage, and great company for the rest of our time together. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Sorry, little announcement. We're gonna do a group photo over there, so if you could please join us when you're ready, that would be great. Thank you.
Food after.